We've got a fantastic show for you tonight. There are some very big birthdays today. Not really. There's Project Runway's Tim Gunn. It's his birthday. And Senator Elizabeth Dole. It's her birthday. Tim Gunn and Elizabeth Dole, very different. One's been in love with Bob Dole for 40 years, and the other one's Elizabeth Dole. Oh, knock it off. Listen, there was an earthquake in LA today. I know! That's how stupid our audience are. They cheered an earthquake. They're dangerous! Luckily, we have the earthquake alarm at CBS. It's me going like this. Ah! Thank goodness I remembered my emergency kit. That's all I'm saying. And by emergency kit, I mean extra underpants. Oh, you can all you like. You weren't here. Like, whoa! It was horrifying. Lindsay Lohan was filming a movie right next to the epicenter. She said the room was shaking, she felt disorientated, she threw up, and then there was the earthquake. Everyone in LA is terrified, but you can't tell because they're all, no, I'm scared. I'm really scared. Oh, really? I'm not. It was a big quake, though. It caused over $2 million in improvements to Joan Rivers. Come on! The quake has stopped, but the aftershocks are still rippling through Kirstie Alley. It's horrifying! Don't you ooh me. Ooh Shakespeare, but don't ooh me. Stay tuned, you'll find out. Amazing guest tonight. Jet Li is here, Belinda Carlisle is here. Come on! Applause die away like some sort of galloping unicorn. It's a great day for America. We had an earthquake today. I went to the bathroom a little bit. Moved that much involuntarily since I had a curry. It's day two of Shark Week, everybody, to be able to drive it. That includes sharks. Now, you know, there are no sharks here on CBS. We're just shamelessly getting on the back of the Discovery Channel Shark Week because we could use the ratings, quite frankly. And that little graphic there, I don't know if you noticed, that was Ryan Seacrest being attacked. Because he was attacked by a shark over the weekend. And by shark, I mean large gay man. Because... shark is the new bear. I didn't really say that for legal reasons. It's a great day for America. It's a great day for Earth. Because the aliens are among us. Finally, we know. This is true. Edgar Mitchell, right, who was the sixth man to walk on the moon, says aliens have been visiting the Earth for 60 years. Look at this. Look. There. There's those aliens. It's written down. It must be true. Admittedly, it's the New York Times, so... No, it's true. And Edgar Mitchell's opinion means something. There's only been 12 men who have walked on the moon, and he's number six. First was Neil Armstrong, then there was Buzz Aldrin. Then Buzz Lightyear. Chewbacca, Captain Kirk. I'm kidding, Captain Kirk never walked on the moon. Too fat for a spacesuit. But some of the moonwalkers are definitely more alien than human. I think you know who I'm talking about. Why is that moonwalking? I always thought the association with the moon and Michael Jackson was very, very weird. I mean, the moon and Michael Jackson are very different. One's in outer space, it's cold and it's white, and then there's the moon. Anyway, Edgar Mitchell, the astronaut, he says he's seen aliens. He says they're terrifying. They're stick thin with the giant heads and the creepy eyes. Do you have a picture of them? Oh, knock it off. That's not aliens. Those are America's lovable anorexic billionaires. The Olsen twins. What's their name again? Mary-Kate and Osama. They're lovely. Aliens are coming to Earth. Shouldn't we build a fence? We don't want aliens coming here taking Earth jobs. Could you imagine a big creepy alien hosting a late night talk show? Bad example. I'm no longer an alien. I've assumed American form. Witness these lovely teeth. I'm no longer European. I smell lovely. See, if the aliens have reached Earth, they must have amazing technology, but they're not sharing it. Shouldn't they be helping us with our problems like the global warming and hunger and disease? To me, I have to say these aliens sound like jerks. They are. Instead of helping us, they're probing us. I say, can't we have both? Can't we? That's right. I'm talking to you, aliens. How does he know about us? I know. With your televisions watching in Area 51. I agree with Edgar Mitchell on the alien thing. No, I don't. But he does have my respect, Edgar Mitchell. After all, he's been to the moon. I bet he lets you know it as well. I've met guys who've been to the moon. They always talk. They work it into every conversation. How do you like this cold weather? Well, it's not as cold as when I was on the moon. Now, that's cold. You think this is cold? Go to the moon, buddy. What's your favorite rock band? The Who. Why? Well, I like their drummer, Keith Moon. Have I mentioned I went to the moon? Do you know why it's called mooning when you show your bare ass? I Googled this today. There's a great website. No. It goes back to the 1600s. People, the mooning, it was because people used to expose their asses to the moon when they were using the outhouse at night. That's why it's called mooning. It sounds a little weak to me, that. I mean, does that mean that nobody went to the bathroom during the day before 1600? God, I'm dying for a go to the bathroom, but 3 more hours of daylight. They also had watches in the 1600s. This watch from the future tells me I only have to wait 3 more hours to... The moon is revered in literature, of course. In Timon of Athens, Shakespeare wrote, "The moon's an errant thief, and her pale fire she snatches from the sun." Don't do me, it's Shakespeare. Who the hell are you? Ooh, Shakespeare? He's one of the greatest writers who ever lived. Ooh! How can you ooh Shakespeare? How dare you? No, he wrote that lovely line. Then he wrote, "Ass, gas or grass, nobody rides for free." The moon's inspired a lot of great pop songs. My favourite is David Bowie's Space Oddity. He wrote that in 1969 when Neil Armstrong was landing on the moon. They're like, Take your protein pills and put your helmet on. I love David Bowie lyrics. You know what he does? He just takes a bunch of words from engineering manuals and then puts a dinosaur name in. It's like, creature from the dome, trajectory engineering, triceratops. Let me get this straight. Let me get this straight. Shakespeare gets an ooh and David Bowie gets a round of applause. Welcome back to the big Shakespearean show, everybody. Now is the winter of our discontent, made glorious summer by the sun of York and all the clouds that lowered upon our house in the deep bosom of the ocean Bereid. Grim-visaged war hath smoothed his wrinkled front, and now instead of mounting barbed steeds to fright the souls of fearful adversaries, he capers namely in a lady's chamber to the lascivious pleasing of a lute. No, that wasn't Shakespeare. I just made that up. Take that, improv all-stars. Actually, it was kind of, it was the start of Richard III, and then I was just doing crap. Like, the first line, I think, was the same. And then I just improvised around it. Shakespeare, I think, when he started off his career, he was like, give me the name of a town. Right, the name of a town, good, and I need an occupation. Give me a tragic romance. Romeo and Juliet, very good. Okay, so, we're here, and the two gentlemen were in Verona. He wasn't into improvisation, Shakespeare. He wrote it all down. Jerk. All right, I can't be yakking to you. I don't have enough time. Or apparently I do. Do we have time for an email? Let me check. No, oh! Actually, that's not entirely true. We do have time for maybe 1 or 12 emails. All right, this is from Richard in New York City. Never heard of it. Dear Craig, what is your favorite Spanish word? I think it would have to be taquito. It's like a taco, only smaller, which is nice because it makes your hand look enormous. I know all the tricks. The taquito is the Spanish version of the mini burger. Not really. I don't know. Let's see. That's from. This is from Ben in Churchville, in New York. Oh God. Sorry, I've got a cough that makes me throw paper on my face. I'm still working out in Las Vegas. I've got the Vegas throat. They call it Vegas throat. By the way, there's a place up in Hollywood Boulevard you can get Vegas throat. Well, never mind. We can cut that out. Hey, this is two from New York. Things are looking up for us on the East Coast. Hey, Craig, have you ever had a crush on one of your teachers? No. Teachers were all alcoholic old guys that beat me up. I had a crush on all of them. That would explain a few things in later life, I think. All right. This is from Greg in Santa Fe in New Mexico. Howdy, Craig. Oh. I saw you in Las Vegas. What's your favorite thing in Vegas? I like the Bellagio fountain. Your friend, Greg. What are you, five? What the hell are you doing? Did your mom help you with this, Greg? First you say you saw him, and then you tell him your thing in Las Vegas, and then he'll tell you his thing in Las Vegas. You like the Bellagio fountain. I enjoy the prostitutes. This is an interesting idea. This is from Sean in Edgewood. I don't know where Edgewood is, but I think it's Illinois. It's not. Maybe, I don't know. There's a 50-to-1 chance it's in Illinois, isn't it? It's not going to be in Hawaii. Right? There's nowhere in Hawaii called Edgewood. It would be Huckalucka Edgewood or something. Maybe not Huckalucka. Anyway, Sean says, there's not a lot of people in Hawaii called Sean, though, either, is there? Maybe there is. I don't know. What do I know? I'm not a geography teacher. Sean says, dear Craig, could you interview an invisible guest? Let's find out. My first guest tonight, the great Sean Connery, everybody. Sean Connery. Good to see you, Sean. Or not see you. I see you're invisible at the moment.
Yes, I'm researching a new movie. In this movie, I play the invisible man. Which is hard for me because I've got a massive penis.
Is it very difficult to be invisible when you're so well endowed, sir?
Yes, that's the hardest part of invisibility, seems to be making the genitals invisible. Especially mine. Because they have a kind of glowing quality.
Well, I'm sorry, Sean, but we're out of time.
Oh, that's a shame. Because I was going to show you my tattoo.
We can't see it.
Yes, I know.
Well, thanks for coming.
Sure, I'm not really here.
Well, who are you then?
I'm just a guy.
Look. I know this isn't working, but I'm committed to it. All right, we'll be right back, everybody. We'll be right back. Don't clap, you'll ruin my concentration. I'm not used to that sound. Anyway, well, that's it. That's all I got. But my first guest tonight is in the movie The Mummy, Tomb of the Dragon Emperor, which is in theaters. That's what I'm talking about! Welcome, Jet. Should I call you Jet?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. It's okay. Well, is that your real name, Jet?
Yeah. My Chinese name, Li Lianjie. When you translate it to English, Jet is Li is put back, Lianjie Li, then people say too long, just take a Lian, Jet Li.
Nice!
Yeah.
Worked out well, because it sounds really sexy in English, like Jet Li. Right. I was going to change my name to Propeller Ferguson or something.
I check it on the internet.
Yeah, yeah.
Only 7 people in America, they call Jet Li. 7.
The 7 people in America?
Yeah, because I want to own the website, jetli.com, but somebody already did it.
Really?
I paid $260 something, buy it back. 7 people call Jet Li.
$260?
ByTheDuckJetLi.com.
That's fine. And did you get to meet the other person called Jet Li?
No, only seven. We talk online. The lawyer talked.
Oh. Yeah.
Can you give me
my name's Jet Li. How funny. That is interesting. Well, you got the website now, though.
Yeah, yeah.
What do you need a website for?
You know, talk to the audience, talk to the friends. All we're right. Family, right?
Yeah, yeah. Nice.
Cheers.
Now, in the clip that we saw, you were fighting Michelle Yeoh.
Yeah.
I love Michelle Yeoh, and you must never hurt her.
Sorry.
Yeah, yeah.
I just got her. Yeah.
Don't.
I already did.
Well, you mustn't do it again. She's very lovely. She's been on the show, Michelle Yeoh. And she may be the one of the most beautiful women, and I have to be careful here, one of the most beautiful women I have ever seen in my life.
No way. He's like my brother.
She's like your brother?
I never treat her like a girl. Really.
This is good news for me, though.
That's the way she like it.
Oh, she does.
This is a call. Hey, brother, we go to the bathroom together, something like that. he's like a boy. He's like a very tough girl.
Right.
Really.
Yeah.
During making this movie, I just saw that he still is the man 15 years ago we fight each other. So I really cut. He stopped.
Really? Did you get cut?
Cut her.
You cut Michelle. You hurt her face?
So. Because I didn't mind you need to tell me earlier.
Yeah, yeah, I know, I should have. Also, I could see how threatened you are by me as well. Hey, listen, we had Jackie Chan on the show. Are you and Jackie friends?
Yeah, we know each other for 25 years.
Yeah, for a long time, right.
Yo, I saw this show this morning. You're talking about cha-cha-cha, you're
no, Jackie was doing that. Jackie was doing that. He was the one going, Jackie Chan.
I
didn't do that. Jackie did that.
Really?
Okay. I would never do. He was going, Jackie Chan, like that to me. But I was talking to him about Sammo Hung, I love Sammo Hung. He's a great artist, isn't he? A great martial artist.
Yeah, he's a very great brothers. Yeah.
Yeah, and he's... The thing about Sammo Hung, I think, is interesting. He's quite... He's larger than you and Jackie, isn't he? He's kind of a... Well, we have a word called portly. Portly. You know, he's kind of like...
Yeah, very heavy.
He's they're very strong. Agile, though. So you don't have to be very thin to do kung fu, then?
No, you can be any size. Just be happy, do it. You know, a lot of people do the highest, the highest. The Japanese, what's the guy do?
Oh, sumo wrestling. Yeah.
He's so strong.
Yeah.
300 pounds.
Now, but sumo, it's not great. It's not, I mean, I'm
sure
it's
a bit.
Yeah, they're very strong, but really.
Not like this.
Yeah, you know, it doesn't, to my eyes, I'm sure to many people it may be different, but to my eyes, it doesn't have the sexiness of kung fu. I mean, a large man in a diaper doesn't really. Now, are you working, are you involved with the Olympics this year? Are you doing the.
Yeah, of course. First of all, Beijing is my hometown. Welcome everybody come to Beijing.
Right.
Thank you. And also I represent martial art.
Right.
Martial art have a special, you know, showing in the Olympics. Also my daughter want to see the opening, so I will bring her to see the opening.
Do your daughters, are they becoming martial artists too?
Yeah, they want to be actor, learning martial arts. But I always share my feeling with him. Oh, do this for 10 minutes. We do this for 30 minutes. So after 5 minutes, I don't want to learn martial art anymore.
I find the older I get, the more often I have to do that. It's true. It's absolutely true. Now, have you seen the movie Kung Fu Panda?
Yeah, I saw it.
It's pretty good, isn't it?
Very good.
Yeah.
I'm so happy. Finally, I find the students. I can retire. Panda there.
But that panda, when the panda does the chopstick thing, that's great, isn't
it? Yeah, I watched the movie with my wife, my two daughter, you know, in the theater. They're just laughing. We were so happy. Then suddenly, I saw three of them crying. I say, what? I say, oh, turtle gone. Turtle. You know the turtle? Master.
Oh, yeah, 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 yeah.
So they're crying.
But he was all right at the end.
And I said, no, the turtle is still here. So very good movie. Very good movie.
Tell me about the foundation you're working with. Because there were rumors a while after the tsunami.
Yep.
There were rumors that you had actually been taken by that. Is that right? Were you there, or was there something involved?
I am there. Yeah.
What?
My whole family take a vacation in Maldives. So the morning the water come, you know, the bad time is water is here. I holding my daughter, good the younger Lord. One, you know, only 1 year old. Hooked by the water, and you know, somebody saved her, and very dangerous. I think God, if you tell me gone, just gone.
Yeah.
So since then, I thought, you know, my wife like a reborn.
Yes.
I really need to pay back to the world. So I started One Foundation. Why is it called One? Because I thought that this earth like a global family.
Right.
Everybody, maybe we're religion different, you know, every language different, but we're a human being. We need to help each other.
Of course.
Simple idea.
Right.
Everyone, every month, donate 1 yuan. What is 20 cents US dollars? Every month, donate 1 yuan together. We
right.
put on the pool, we help the poor, we help the people who need money. Tell the weather like a Sichuan earthquake.
And how
we did
how,
a lot of work.
Is it all about working with people who've suffered from natural disasters? Is that
this
the
most important thing? Also,
right.
the other education, poor people, take care. Think about a million people, a billion, not a million, billion people in China.
Yeah.
They have a lot of people. You donate 1 yuan, put it together. How much? We okay. really can change our life.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And how if someone wanted to be to donate something to your foundation or to help you with that, how would they be able to help you?
We have a website called the One Foundation website.
One Foundation website?
Yeah, like a Sichuan earthquake.
Right.
I just put a news on the online. So in 7 days, I got a 50 million Chinese
yuan. That is fantastic.
From all over the world.
Well done.
Thank
well
you.
Done.
Everybody.
So one foundation website. Jet Li, everybody, we'll be right back.
Thank you.
It's okay. It's okay. Welcome back, everybody. Welcome back to the big earthquake survivor edition. Don't worry, that was just me. If I do that, does it feel like an earthquake in your house? Or are you watching from bed? Did the earth move for you? You too, ladies. That doesn't make any sense. My next guest is an 80s music icon. The Regeneration Tour 2008, has it started yet? Is she doing it? Yeah, well, she's doing it. Well, great, and she's here now to be part of it. Please welcome the adorable and fantastic Belinda Carlisle, everybody. Welcome, Belinda.
Hi.
And very nice to see you.
Same you.
Did you feel the earthquake today?
Nope.
You did?
I was in Japan last week too, and during we had that big earthquake in Japan.
Are you the Typhoid Mary of earthquakes?
They're following me. I'm
yeah,
sure.
It's
them
kind
the
of
aliens,
scary.
Too.
Yeah. No, there are no aliens here. Do you believe in aliens?
Do you have an hour?
Actually, yes. Come on, let's hear it. Do
yeah.
you believe in aliens?
Oh, I think there's the Greys and the Reptilians.
Oh,
yeah,
right, okay. I think we've hit pay dirt
you
with you.
You
no, come on,
you
let's hear.
No, you don't want to go there with
yes,
me, honestly.
Yes, I do.
No, I think there could be, yeah.
All right, okay. Yeah. Anything else you believe in?
Oh, a lot of things.
Leprechauns.
I do think there's leprechauns and fairies.
Do
yeah.
you really?
Yeah.
Well, there's a club up in West Hollywood called Leprechauns and Fairies.
Well.
You can touch them for luck.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Now, you don't live... I thought you moved out of L.A. because of the earthquakes. Wasn't that
the fires and the floods and the riots.
Yeah, it's all nice and biblical. I like it.
No, we left about 15 years ago, and we moved to France.
Whereabouts in France do you live?
In the south, near Nice.
Very nice.
Yeah,
yeah, that's very, very
nice.
Nice is nice. That's why they called it that. It is very nice. Do you speak French?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, good.
Yeah, pretty good.
Really?
Pretty good, yeah.
Do you enjoy cheese?
No, I don't eat much cheese.
They make great cheese in France. The soft cheeses are lovely.
I know. No, I don't drink. I don't drink wine. Don't eat cheese.
What the hell do you do there?
Are you allowed to... I don't have any French friends.
Do you really? No. Well, neither do I. But that's just, you know.
No, but I do. I do eat baguettes and olive oil.
Right.
And a lot of butter too.
Really?
Yeah.
You look very well on it.
Well, you know. Whatever.
No, yeah. Really. Now, listen, tell me about your donkey sanctuary. Have you got it started yet?
No. It's something that I've always wanted to do, and I'm back and forth to India, and I met these people that have an animal sanctuary in India. And
for
that's
donkeys.
Kind of... No, well, they started the donkey sanctuary, and it became dogs. There's no animal services there. So
right.
It's kind of my next project that I'm going
to
work on.
What do donkeys have to be saved from? Themselves,
well,
probably.
They're
crazy ideas.
Donkeys, they're hardworking, you know, beasts of burden, and they don't get a lot of glory.
Do people still use donkeys
for stuff?
Really?
Yeah, they do.
Well, for instead of cars and stuff?
For hard labor.
All right.
Yeah.
What about circuses? Do they ever have donkeys?
I don't go to circuses.
You don't? What about Cirque du Soleil? They're French-Canadian, but still kind of French.
Don't do circuses.
No, but there's no animals in
the circus. That's fine.
No, it's just humans that are abused in there.
Yeah. That's okay. No, that's fine.
No, they're not abused, of course. They balance like crazy. Have you never been to Vegas?
Oh, yeah, I go to Vegas quite a bit.
Well, then they've got Ka and O and Mystère.
No, that stuff is great.
Yes, that's what I'm saying. That's the new type of circus.
Yeah, new animals.
But you're a big animal rights advocate now.
I don't like circuses that use animals. And I don't, I'm not a fur person at all.
Really?
Mm-mm.
What about if you were freezing and someone offered you a donkey skin coat?
No, I wouldn't do it. No way.
Now you're just like,
I'll brave it.
Yeah, no, it's good. And anyway, it's the south of France. It's not that cold.
No, it's not.
No. It's lovely weather there, isn't it?
Well, we have seasons. You know, up where we are, we have sometimes a little bit of snow.
Do you know what they call it in France? Saison.
Wow. You speak French, too.
Oui.
That's good. Very good.
Oui.
Oui.
Yeah. Now, tell me about the tour, the Regeneration Tour. Who else is on it?
Well, ABC, Human League, Flock of
Human Seagulls. League, don't you want me? Not that?
They're really good lines.
Yeah. Oh, I like them.
No, and it's for 3.5 weeks, and a lot of dates in the States and in Mexico.
Well, that's nice. Well, and you're going to come back and play a song for us, is that right?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Belinda Carlisle, everybody. Cheer for everybody. Drink up there, little buddy. This is my shark. My shark I got for Shark Week. His name's Derek. Drink up there, Derek. Oh, I got a sore throat. I know, Derek, I know. There you are. Soon you'll be able to grow strong and mighty, and then you can eat me. All right. Now, please welcome back, performing her hit, Heaven on Earth, the lovely Belinda Carlisle, everybody. Belinda Carlisle. I wanted to use a donkey for that bit. I'm kidding. Anyway, it's not a real kitten. It's just a picture of a kitten. And then when its head explodes, it's a human skull inside. It's kind of like Ghost Rider. That's an awesome movie, Ghost Rider, isn't it? I love that movie. It's a movie where there's a guy rides a motorcycle and it's a skeleton and he's on fire. If you don't like that movie, go and join Al-Qaeda. Go on. Anyway, we learned today there was an earthquake in Los Angeles today, and we learned that I went to the bathroom a little bit. We learned that when I misquote Shakespeare's opening paragraph to Richard III, there'll be a lot of emails coming my way, I'm sure, and internet action about how I'd got the opening passage to Richard III wrong. And I thought to myself, you know, I'll just reply to that the way Shakespeare would. I'd like to thank my guests, Jet Li, Belinda Carlisle, and the invisible Sean Connery. Please, don't, you'll embarrass him, he's still there. All right, I'm done. I'll see you tomorrow, and I'm going to try and have a little bit more action. Perhaps I've said too much. Good night, everybody.